Hello, this is Nikki from Nikki's Crafting Corner. Welcome back to my channel. I have bound a lot of blank journals recently, and that left me with all this. Strips in every color, thick and thin. These are cardboard strips, thin strips. Some are already kind of folded, and I really have to get rid of them, and I don't want to throw them away because there are some really nice ones like this one. This is from the autumn kit from Beth at Yes I Made It Myself, and I really want to use them, and I thought I want to do some mini books again. These are already folded. They are perfect for a little very thick mini book. So I want to do that today, and for a cover I want to use a page of an old children's book. I have gone through my children's books from my kids and we have decluttered, and I want to use these books because the paper is quite thick for the cover of my mini books. So I want to prepare all the little mini books, and then I want to cut the cover for them. Okay, let's go. I want to start with this one, as this is already perfectly bound and put together. These are papers I have dyed myself. This is avocado dyed paper, coffee dyed paper. This is dyed with food color in purple. This is just a little bit tea dyed, and this is my fruit tea dyed paper. It's kind of grayish, so that's it. Okay, I want to cut these in half, and then I want to use half of it to make a little mini book. So let's cut these first. I want to cut them all at once. So like this, and then this will be one book, and this will be the second book. Okay, so these will be really thick, but I think this is so much fun. So let me just get the edges kind of straight, and with this we can get rid of the fold that's already there. So I want it to be quick and easy. Okay, just needs the cover. This one is ready to go. So let's see. I quite like this frayed edge here, so I will leave it on this. I don't have any folds here, so this will be as it is. So really junky and chunky. Okay, so let's see to the cover for them. As I said, I want to use this children's book page, and I think I want to start with this one. Do I want it like this? So I would have, let me see, I would have the clock there. Yeah, I think that's cute. So I just, these are the same height. I just eyeball the height. I don't like to measure. So a smidge bigger than my papers. That's it, but I have to get rid of all the scraps over there. Let me just kind of shuffle them away. Okay, so let's measure again. Okay. This is a kind of straight. Okay. worked out perfectly. And then just wrap this around. I want it the other way because I want to see the clock. Okay. Yeah, perfect. And I just cut this off. So like this. So I have these papers stick out. I think that's really cute. Okay. I hope I can staple this thick booklet. Let me see if this will work. If this will work. I just do one staple in the middle. That's enough for this little book. Oh, this is so cute. And I think I want a little bit of twine all around. This is the perfect color for this little book. Oh, this is so cute. I love that. So this thick little book really needs something to hold it together. Oh, this is so cute. Okay, so this is what I want to do today. I will do a lot, and you don't have to see every book I make, but I will show you the result. So this is a very quick video. So see you soon. Okay, I'm back. This is what I did so far. So this is the little book I made together with you, and I have made another one that has got a little bow on it, and then I did a lot of other books. So these one have different sizes, and I have punched out some circles. I already had some punch outs, and I did my I used my circle punch, which is an inch circle punch, and I embellished these little books with my circle punch. They have a different number of pages in them. Some have a cover from the DigiKit from Beth, and some have ripped pages in them. So these are all different kind of books. A few books, I punched a hole in them so I can use them as a dangle somewhere. So I haven't counted them, but they are a lot. And I have a lot of strips left. So I have used approximately, I think, half of my strips. And the other thing that I did are these little notebooks or notepads. I just stapled some strips together. I used my children's book page to staple all of them together, and I have punched a hole in some and put a safety pin in them so I can use them as a dangle as well. So all these different, this is a small one. I just used some leftover squares. So they are all different, and they are really a lot. Okay. So this is what I did. This is everything. Really a lot, but I already have a lot of strips left, so I can do many, many more. Okay, so this was a very quick video just to show you how I use up my scraps, and to give you some ideas and inspiration. And yeah, let's enjoy our scraps. Bye.